over the phone in those 10 to 12 minutes that we spent together on the way to the hospital. But just that 12 minutes had such a long-lasting impact on me. I can only imagine what impact he's had on the community that he served, the officers who served with him on a daily basis.
Officer Mattson is the third local law enforcement officer to die in the line of duty since the start of the year. And tonight there are new efforts to support their families. ABC Action News reporter Julie Salamone shows us how these tragedies have hit home for one local business.
Homeowners across Tampa Bay sharing photos of their swimming pools on social media. Turn the lights blue for law enforcement.
I think us turning the pools blue is just the least we can do to show our support, especially during these times when we have these fallen officers.
Tropical Escapes Pool Builders announcing on Facebook it will donate a portion of its proceeds until June to the three families who lost their loved one in the line of duty. All three officers died while protecting our community. Hillsborough County Deputy Brian Levine was one shift away from retirement. Pinellas County Deputy Michael Megley was the first deputy killed in the line of duty in the history of the Pinellas County Sheriff's Office. And just this week, Tampa Police Officer Jesse Mattson died while stopping a wrong-way driver.
For me, like, I have two small kids as well, so, like, I just can't imagine, you know, my wife and my kids and my parents getting that call and, like, that knock on the door.
Brett Morris has a wife and two small children. He's worked for Tropical Escape since 2020, but prior to that, he spent a decade with the Pasco County Sheriff's Office.
Unfortunately, you take these terrible situations to, like, bring the light to the dangers of the job.
Morris hopes more pools light up blue. He knows the risk is real for law enforcement.
I hope the community realizes these men and women are leaving their two-year-old kids and their families to go out and potentially not come home at the end of the day.
In Pasco County, Julie Salmon, ABC Action News.